Officer Sean Wallace shot Alan Gomez in the back as he walked into his home because he thought Gomez was holding a gun, but it wasn't. It was a kitchen utensil. Family members called police saying Gomez was holding them hostage with a rifle, and neighbors heard Gomez firing that weapon. Action 7 News reporter Lana Gold is live to explain. Wallace is no stranger to these shootings.
Doug and Shelley, yesterday's shooting at this home in Northeast Albuquerque wasn't the first for Officer Wallace. He's actually fired at three suspects in the last few years, killing two of them. He was also the source of several lawsuits. On Tuesday, APD Officer Sean Wallace shot and killed Alan Gomez, a wanted man with a long criminal history. That shooting comes almost a year after Wallace shot and wounded a suspected car thief who climbed on top of a roof in Northeast Albuquerque. The shooting was ruled justified. And before Wallace got hired at APD, he was a state police officer. In 2005, Wallace shot and killed a Chimayo man who tried to run Wallace over in his truck during a heroin investigation. Even though that shooting was also ruled justified, the suspect's family won a $235,000 wrongful death lawsuit. And there were more legal battles for Wallace in 2003, when a Las Vegas man sued him for allegedly pulling him over and beating him up. The man was supposedly paid money to drop the suit that was eventually settled.
Don't demonize the people that are doing the job that we pay them to protect us.
This neighbor, who lives feet away from Tuesday's shooting, defends Officer Wallace.
The people that are complaining about it, if they needed him to be there to save their life, they'd want him there.
Especially since the man who was killed put her life at risk, firing his rifle in the front yard.
Those bullets have to come down, and they may hurt somebody. And it's nothing to joke about, you know, it's nothing to take lightly.
APD knew about Wallace's history with state police when he was hired, but it wasn't a problem because he wasn't charged or convicted. Also, it's common for police to be named in lawsuits. Meanwhile, Wallace is on three-day paid leave while the shooting is investigated. Reporting live in Northeast Albuquerque, Alana Gold, KOAT, Action 7 News.
Coming up at 6, you're going to hear from the family member who was held hostage inside that home when he shares his terrifying experience.